Hello to all my beautiful viewers out there. Today we're going to be talking about the upcoming release of the Nike Dunk Low Biotech colorway. You heard it right, folks. Yes, 6 years since the last release of the Nike Dunk Low Biotech. Today, on December 10th, we are getting a retro of the Nike Dunk Low Biotech colorway. This colorway originally debuted in a Japan exclusive capsule back in 2002. Then it got a general release in adult sizing in 2013 and a children's sizing in 2015. I would hate to be a fan of Dunks, or more specifically Dunk Low Biotechs, and then have children's sizing get a release in 2015 and not adult sizing. That would honestly suck. But you know what? Nike's not going to disappoint you too much, because today, on December 10th, we are getting a release of the Nike Dunk Low Biotech just for you guys. So, as I mentioned, it has released quite a few times in the past. There is some key differences that we have to talk about in this video, specifically to do with this Dunk Low and Dunk SB Lows, just to cover that, just so nobody gets confused. As I said, the colorway is also coming out today. It hasn't dropped yet. In Australian time, it's dropping at 10 p.m. So there is a little bit of time still until it actually gets released, but the rest of the world will be getting it on the 10th on Nike sneakers, but Australians don't necessarily get it as soon as it hits the 10th of December. We have to wait till almost the end of the 10th of December, so we all get it at the same time as the rest of the world, because the rest of the world will clock over to the 10th of December at 10 p.m. in our time. So that's why we get it super late into the night. It's such a weird system, but I suppose it works out, because then essentially everyone can get the sneakers at the same time. Whatever, I suppose. But yeah, we are getting it at 10 p.m. on Nike sneakers. Just go on Nike.com, go upcoming, and then it is there. For the rest of the world, same situation, but I have a Hypebeast article that'll perfectly explain all the details to do with that. So we should jump over to the Hypebeast article and have a look at the Nike Dunk Low Biotech. Now, for once, my head is actually not covering the title of the article, so we can all read it together, but here we go. A closer look at the Nike Dunk Low Biotech. Now, notice how it says Nike Dunk Low and not Nike SB Dunk Low Biotech. That's because this is a Nike release, not a Nike SB release. Now, a lot of people do know this, but some people might not know this, so I thought I would just cover it quickly. There is a big difference between Nike and Nike SB releases when they do Dunks. Dunks were originally basketball shoes released in 1985, and then only in the early 2000s did we get a SB variant of the Dunk, as skaters used to use Dunks throughout the 90s, because it's just a perfect perfect skating shoe. Look at it. Hard rubber sole and a very sturdy, maybe in this case a suede, but in a lot of cases leather upper, so it would just be the perfect skating shoe. Now, obviously this has changed. Not a lot of people would use Nike Dunks or Nike SB Dunks for skating these days. They're more of a collector's piece, but I thought I would just establish that there are key differences between the Nike SB Dunk and the Nike Dunk. The Nike Dunk is more like a basketball shoe. It has a thinner tongue and does not have a lot of the features that the Nike SB Dunk does, which is a wider fit and a thicker tongue. Now, I personally wouldn't be able to confirm the wider fit. Those are just things that I've read on the internet, that it is slightly wider than a Nike Dunk release. I, of course, don't have any Nike Dunks or Nike SB Dunks, because they don't make them that big. They don't make them into a 16 or 17. So I miss out on Nike SB Dunks and Nike Dunks, and I just go for Jordans and Jordan 1s, because that's all I can get. That's all they make. Unfortunately, Nike SB and Nike do not make Dunks big enough for me, but that's okay. But I thought I would just mention that there is a difference between Dunks and not SB Dunks, just so you don't get confused. And if you've been collecting SB Dunks this whole time, and then you buy Dunks and you're like, what the heck, this looks totally different. So it is slightly different, and you'll be able to see details like the thinner tongues when we go over the details. So let's have a look. After an official release date was announced recently, the reissue of the Nike Dunk Low Biotech has now received a closer look. So we'll have a look at some of those photos that they've got for us as well. The sneaker made its debut way back in 2002. I would have been 3 years old when this thing debuted. That is a crazy thought. As part of a Japan exclusive capsule, before returning again with a 2013 general release. There you go. So if you didn't buy it in 2002, you would have had to wait 11 years until the next release. That is crazy. And a 2015 children's sizing. So if you didn't fit into children's sizing, you would have had to wait 11 years from 2002 to get it in 2013. And if you missed out in 2013 and didn't get the 2002 pair, you'd have had to wait all the way now until 2019 to get the pair. But I doubt there is like that many hardcore Viatech fans that need to get this Nike Dunk Low, but you never know. The Viatech colorway sees a number of bold tones hitting the sneaker's premium suede upper, with purple sections sitting on the heel and outsole, as well as orange midfoot portion, blue and red towards the toe box, and green touches near the collar. Elsewhere, the sneaker features a tan swoosh and a white midsole, keeping it similar to its 2013 predecessor, while the black heel stitching is faithful to the 2002 original. So essentially, what they did for the 2019 release is grab a little bit of the 2002 details, a little bit of the 2013 details, chucked them in a melting pot, and stirred that stuff together to make this 2019 Frankenstein Viatech. Some people may not be okay with this because a lot of Dunk, well, I say this from a Jordan collector's perspective, a lot of Dunk collectors, I assume, are very much like Jordan collectors, where they want it true to the original without variation. So some people that like the 2002 original release may not like this 2019 release because it's not true to the original. Again, that comes down to your personal opinion. I don't mind slight change of details too much in Jordan releases, retro releases, really, as long as it's to the benefit of the shoe and it's not been done out of just some no reason, like, crap, and they just, like, chuck it in for no reason. I don't like that. If there's justification behind it, then I'll be like, yeah, okay, I accept that. Take an up close look at the Nike Dunk Low Viatech in the gallery above, and expect the colorful sneaker to arrive via Nike Sneakers and select stockists on December 10th. So it may be releasing in some skateboarding stores near you. I would definitely check with them, but if you can't be bothered doing that and just want a nice, easy, comfy cop online, go with the Nike Sneakers option. And in other footwear news, get an official look at the Off-White Nike Waffle Racer SP. So I will be talking about that. I've already made like 4 videos covering that. The Nike Off-White Waffle Racer pack is finally getting an actual release date. I've covered it for the past 4 months. If you've been following the channel for a while, you'll definitely know that. That'll be the next video releasing, guys. So if you're interested in seeing me cover that video, covering that sneaker release, subscribe to the channel and definitely get ready for the next video to come up. But we'll go back to talking about the Viatechs and having a look at these images. So as you can see, it did talk about having a purple upper and a purple outsole. Obviously, two different tones of purple here being used. We'll go through and have a look at it. So it's got a blue toe box with a red outer toe box, orange side panels there, purple back heel side panel there, bit of green at the back, closer zoomed in images of the toe box of the side. Here we go. So I don't know if you can tell too well. You might have a pair of SB Dunks that you can look at and be like, oh, okay, I can see the visible difference. But this tongue is a lot thinner just by having a look at it. You would be able to instantly notice if this was an SB release because it would have SB down here. But also the tongue would be a lot thicker. It would be probably like, it would appear like that on the actual photos. It would just be really, really thick. This looks like a really thin tongue and you can tell just by looking at the photos of it. Let's keep going through. There we go. So black stitching on the back of it, as it talked about in the description below. Some people may not be happy with this, but some people might be really ecstatic about it. Again, it comes down to your personal opinion. How do you feel about it? Let me know how you feel about the black stitching, if that's an issue for you, in that comment section below. But most people won't mind too much. Some people might have preferred a more colorful stitching on the back, because the black sort of doesn't work well with all the use of color here, even though it has black eyelets. It all depends. It comes down to personal preference. I think the black is totally fine. I like the use of black to tone down the inside of it and also the eyelets, while the Viatech colors, you know, basically speak for the sneaker all over it. So it is a very cool looking dunk. They do the Viatech colorway on a bunch of other shoes as well. They did them on some, I think, Air Max 90s, I want to say, quite recently, probably about 2 months ago, maybe a month ago. I definitely remember that. Some mates of mine were interested in them. Big mates of mine that are big Air Max 90 collectors. But I would say that the Viatek colorway definitely complements the Dunk theme. I like it that they've kept it all suede and haven't changed any materials to leather or anything like that. It basically, if they changed it to any other materials, it would start looking more like the What the Dunks instead of the Viatek Dunks. And I don't know, you could argue that the Viatek is basically just like the poor man's What the colorway, but that, you know, each to their own. I mean, obviously not all of us can afford the What the Dunks, and the Viatek Dunks are probably the next best thing if you want a mix match colored dunk. So that's probably the next best thing. It's a very cool release. As mentioned below, it has the release date of December 10th, 12 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, but for me, it's 10 p.m. AEDT, Australian Eastern Daylight Savings Time. I know. How long is that Australian time zone name? Yeah, so for Australia, it's releasing 10 p.m. Australian Eastern Daylight Savings Time. Allegedly, it's releasing 12 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, but I would go on Nike Sneakers and confirm that with yourself just to make sure that it is the correct, and also then you can have a good idea of when they're releasing if you're interested. Now, I want to know your thoughts and opinions, guys. How do you feel about the Nike Dunk Low Viatek? Would you have preferred them to go with the SB route of a thicker tongue, or do you like it that it stays more true to the retro of the 2002 pairs and the 2013 pairs, where they've kept it a Nike Dunk Low? How do you feel about that? If you're a bit confused as well on how to style this, I would say this shoe is obviously doing a lot of the talking, so style it with a basic outfit and get that shoe to do the talking. I thought I'd just add that in quickly for anyone interested, but I would say because this shoe is very loud, it's got a lot going on, definitely keep your outfit nice and simple. But let me know how you feel about it all in the comment section below and how you would style it, and tell me how you do it. Black jeans, black chinos, let me know everything you got to say about them in the comment section below. And that's all we've really got to say about the upcoming release of the Nike Dunk Low Viatek colorway, guys. It's a pretty steezy colorway. I would wear it with very, very basic outfits, as I was talking about just before. It's such a loud shoe that some people might not like it because the Viatek colorway is just a bit too much for them. But I think really loud shoes, they can be worn. You've just got to wear a super basic outfit. I know really loud shoes aren't for everyone, but let me know if you're gonna pick them up. Let me know if you're super keen on them. They are a very nice colorway. I'm a fan of loud shoes, but you just can't wear loud shoes with, well, you can, but I wouldn't do it. I wouldn't wear loud shoes with a loud outfit. I'd keep it loud shoes, quiet outfit, quiet shoes, loud outfit. One of the two. I wouldn't have them both together. That's not for me. But yeah, it is a very nice sneaker, very nice Dunk Low. Use of materials is really cool. The colors look really nice. Let me know how you feel about it in that comment section below. Thank you for tuning in today, guys. Don't forget to like the video, comment on the video, subscribe to the channel if you're not subscribed already. I will put the article in the description section below if you want to have a read, and then you can also find the link to go to the Nike page off of the article as well if you're interested in picking them up as soon as possible. And that is everything I've really got to say. Don't forget to follow the socials in the description section before I head off. Facebook page, the Instagram page, come on, guys. That's all. So until the next streetwear video, until the next sneaker video, guys, I'll catch you later.